Hi, my name is Anthony. I work with Bill's Equipment Supply, and I'm going to show you the operations of our Genie 3420 electric tow boom. This is a demonstration of how to properly operate the tow boom. For your safety, I would refer to the operator's manual and safety book inside the compartment. And we will also, when you rent this machine, go over operation instructions with you. So the first thing you want to do is, after you get this to your house or your resident, before you unhook from your truck, is set your parking brake. From there, you can start unchaining the boom from your truck. Drop chains off. Bring these up off the ground so they're not in the way. Then you pull your collar pin out, slide the collar back, and it releases the hitch from the tongue of the ball. From there, you want to put your leg jack down, lock it back into place, and start cranking down. And raise the boom off the hitch of your truck. Now you're gonna pull your emergency stop out, make sure it's out. Turn your key to the right to your ground control functions. Your blue and yellow are the operations of the up and down of the machine. The solid black one here is for the self-levelers of your four outriggers. That's the only thing it will be used for. You will press the black one and the yellow one at the same time, and all four of the outrigger arms will come down simultaneously. And once these outrigger arms touch the ground, the indicator lights will light up saying that the outriggers have contact with the ground. Now you keep pressing, holding this button, and this machine will jockey itself to level itself out. The steady tone you hear means the machine is level. Now I'm going to show you guys how to put on a harness, which is a requirement for any aerial booms that we rent. You can rent them from us, or you can go across to our sales division and purchase one. So, looks like a parachute strap is what it looks like. Swing it over just like a coat. You're gonna strap your little chest piece. Your leg straps go through your legs. Tighten it down. Same with the right one. Make sure everything is secure. You got your harness, your hook to secure to the basket of the lift. For now, you can just strap it through the carrier hook. From there, you will come over here. You're going to turn your key to the left to the basket controls. The outrigger lights will stay on. Once you do that, you want to come over here to your boom lock, which is this little lever right here. You pull the lever back and up, drop it down. That now the boom is unlocked and you will be able to operate it from the basket. Enter your basket. Slide the little bar up, step up, let the bar slide down. Now, for your harness lock, you have two of them on each side, one on the right and one on the left. Take your hook, slide it through, and then you're ready to operate the boom. from here, you want to do the same as you did on the ground controls. Make sure your emergency stop is pulled up. You pull that up. And your blue is up, yellow is down. So on the diagram, it shows what each control button does. So I'm going to go through them for you. The first one brings the main boom up here. The second one does your knuckle. And the third one to the top is your extent, does your extension of your basket. This machine will also do 360 degrees, and I'll show you that. You can completely spin this thing all the way around. In each direction, right and left. So once you're done doing your job, you want to get this thing back in the middle and you want to get it center. You want to get your V in the front here into the cradle. You can be a quarter inch on each side to the right or left, and it will slide down in. I will demonstrate it for you. Holy. And you want to make sure you get everything sucked back in before you drop the boom back down. Just like that. And then from there, you hit your emergency stop. Remove your harness from the safety bar. And then exit the basket. After you exit your basket, you can remove your harness. You want to come back over here. Lock the boom back into place. From there, you're going to want to turn your key back to the right to the ground controls. And then you're going to want to bring your outrigger's arms up. So you're going to press the blue button and your black button, and it'll drop the machine back down. Then you press the blue button and the black button, and it'll bring these outrigger arms back up. And you want to keep pressing it until the arms are completely stowed in the proper position. From there, turn your key to the off position. Remove your key. Once you get it hooked back up to your ball, before you finish chaining up or anything, you want to remove the parking brake so it is in the transport position. Then after you remove your parking brake, you'll go ahead and crank up your jack to where it is off the ground, pull the pin out, pull it up, lock your jack back in, rechain up to your truck, transport it back to us, and we'll take it from there. On the back of the boom, if you have it for a 24-hour period, you have your black cord here, is your charger for your batteries. Also has a label sticker of what it is. Your 110 or your 115. Accessory power is your yellow, which will give you power to your junction box. If you need to charge batteries or you have anything electric, you can run power from the basket up in the air.